development manager, EPAM Systems. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation and gracing the occasion. It's a great honor to invite Dr. C.V. Gururao Garu, Director of SREC, to occupy his place onto the dais. I now request Dr. V. Mahesh, Principal of SREC, to come onto the dais. And now we have a prayer song by Ms. Srinidhi Deshpande.
Respected Principal of SREGW, Dr. I. Rajasri Garu, Dean Academics, Dean Student Welfare, Heads of Department, my dear colleagues, students, parents, a very good evening to one and all. Thank you each and every one of you for being here with us today. Today marks our third placement success meeting and we are proud to be able to host this meet today at this wonderful place. Before I get started, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to all who generously helped us to plan this event. In today's gathering, I would like to focus on initiatives and programs that have been conducted during the academic year 2018-19. The Center for Student Services and Placement at SREC majorly focuses on training, career guidance and placements. To make industry ready, we introduced industry-relevant curriculum and we involve industry experts to teach the courses. Industries like ABE Semiconductors from Chennai, Gill Instruments from Bangalore, Farana Solutions, Digital Link India, Acromation Technologies from Hyderabad are the few industries which involved in our curriculum design and delivery during this semester. Training at SREC is a regular part. For second year and third year, 2 hours per week in the timetable itself is dedicated to improve aptitude communication skills and soft skills. We made business communication and public speaking as a part of curriculum for all second BTEC students, which is a mandatory course to improve the soft skills. Apart from this, CSSP conducts
company-specific training for final-year students. We are happy to announce more than 400 hours of company-specific trainings were given for all eligible final-year students for the companies like Infosys, Wipro, Cognizant, Syntel, TCS, etc. This year, we proudly announced that we had 421 placements, out of which 324 placements are from SRDC and 97 are from Singapore Institute of Technology for Women. 48 companies to date, with the highest package being 10 lakhs and least package as 1.8 lakhs, median salary being 3.5 lakhs, are there out of these 421 placements. 70% of our placements are in IT sector, 20% are from core companies, and 10% are in associate companies like business. SRDC followed choice-based credit system starting from this batch onwards, means the students who are sitting over here, for these students we enabled it, where they completed their fourth year second semester courses before they come to fourth year second semester, and 110 students of mechanical ECE and CSE, is mechanical ECE student avail this facility, out of which 20 plus students they joined the company in fourth year second semester itself. Our students are selected for major MNCs like TCS, Wipro, Cognizant, Infosys, Varana, OpenText, Baidu's, IBS, Syntel, and the list goes on. We are expecting another 50 plus placements at the end of this academic year, as we have some of the companies scheduled to visit as our students are having examination during this time. We also encourage students to take online assessment platforms. Most of our students have taken CoQIPS and AMCAT, by which most of the students got placement opportunities. We hope that in coming years we will be able to support our students more efficiently in terms of placements as well as higher education, and also guide them to pursue their career in their field of choice. I don't want to take too much of time, and if you have any questions, suggestions, clarification, or just want to say hi, you can find me over here in the lobby. Thank you very much for being here. Have a great evening. Thank you.
At SREC to meet the industry needs. Thank you, Srinidhi. Honorable dignitaries and the guests, the chief guest of today, Sri Emmanuel Bosila Garu, Senior Manager, Repam Solutions, Chairman of SR Education Academy, Sri Vardareddy Garu, Director Dr. C.V. Guru Rao Garu, Principal of SREC Dr. V. Venkatesh, Principal of SRITW Dr. I. Rajasvi, Deans, Heads of Departments, my colleagues, staff, press and media, ladies and gentlemen, and all my wonderful students sitting here, a very good evening to all of you. Firstly, I'd like to congratulate all the students for getting placed, and I'd also extend my congratulations to the proud parents who are here to receive the offer letters along with their words on the dais. And all the placed students of SRDC and SRITW eagerly wait for this day so that they can come and take the offer letters along with their parents. Today, as Dean Academics of this Institute, I'd like to brief about the curriculum reforms that have been happening. SREC is continuously updating its curriculum to meet the industry and global needs by involving professors from IITs, NITs, and also from industry. We have designed the curriculum based on four key differentiators, which we call them as four I's. The first I stands for innovation, creativity, and entrepreneurial mindset. The second I is interdisciplinary learning. Third I stands for industry relevance. And the fourth I is information technology. The BT curriculum is designed keeping in mind the need to produce well-rounded graduates, many of you who will join the technology industry or in managerial roles, or join the administrative services as technocrats, while a few aspire to research careers. Some may even go on to become entrepreneurs. Thus, at SREC, the students are exposed to a broad range of knowledge and skills that will enable them to perform well in tomorrow's increasingly complex world. The electives in the discipline will enable the students to develop significant knowledge in a specialized area with exposure to research trends and developments. The category of free and open electives outside the chosen discipline enable the student to obtain significant interdisciplinary knowledge. The student can consult a faculty advisor with regard to the planning of curriculum and other academic issues. An important aspect of the curriculum is the integration of innovation and design. In the first year, we have introduced product design studio. In the second year, we have smart system design and engineering design process. At the third year level, the students have an option of choosing open elective tracks either in cognitive science, NEST for social, NEST or social innovation. In social innovation, which we call as EPICS, students explore issues or problems of society and propose technology-based solutions. Then NEST, which we call as NEST for entrepreneurship in science and technology. The track focuses on skill set related to creating ideas, communicating and commercializing ideas, leading innovation, and finally making it to come live with the help of our incubation center, our technology business incubator, SRIX. The professional elective tracks are supported by interdisciplinary centers, which are Center for Artificial Intelligence and Deep Learning, Center for IoT and ESDM Technologies, Center for Emerging Energy Technologies, Center for Material and Manufacturing, Center for Construction Methods and Materials. All our professional electives are offered through our centers. Overall, the curriculum at SREC is designed to encourage and enable the student to become well-qualified and well-rounded engineers in all aspects. We have also understood the importance of enhancing the teaching quality of our faculty. And in this regard, 50 plus of our faculty are certified as International Engineering Educators by Indo-US Collaboration for Engineering Education. We have also seen a good response among the students because we have made learning interesting by introducing outcome-based education and project-based learning. The students of SREC are involved either in a course project or a mini project or a certification every semester. This helps them keep abreast of the new technologies, giving them the experience of what real engineering is about. SR Engineering College continues to be a pace setter not only in Warangal but in the whole state as well. Our strong positioning is due to the quality of the academic staff the institute engages, the quality of learning and teaching resources the institute avails to its staff and students. Finally, it is the students who play an important role in uplifting the standards of this institute and keep the SR flag high. I'll not take much of your time, I'll just give you a small message to the students. When you are in SREC, you are always guided, mentored and taken care of. But today, you're stepping into the industry and there you might not have a second chance for everything. So whatever you do in whichever company you're working, work with full commitment and give your 100% and success will reach you within no time. I wish you all have a successful career and you all scale to heights and make your parents and the alma mater proud. Ladies and gentlemen, once again I thank you all for being here. We thank you for being with us this evening. It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for a brief report. I now request Dr. I. Rajashree, Principal of SRITW, to address the gathering.
Chairman Sri Varada Reddy Garu, today's chief guest, Emmanuel Gosla Garu, and Director C. V. Gurrao Garu, SREC Principal Dr. V. Mahesh Garu, and various heads of the department, deans, students, and parents, staff and supporting staff, a very good evening to one and all. So first of all, I would like to congratulate all the students and parents for getting placements. And it is a pride moment for all the students and parents to be a part of this wonderful evening. My wholehearted thanks to all the parents for your continuous support and your timely suggestions really helped us to move forward. Especially in SRITW, there is a tremendous development both in technically and in all the aspects. We have received so many gratitude from the parents. So first of all, SRITW is established with a clear vision to empower women in the field of engineering and technology and transform them into innovators, leaders and entrepreneurs. And SRITW both in academically also stood first in the university in recently released examinations. And we also established a new gen IEDC center and it is the in entire Telangana, SRIDW is the only one women's engineering college which established NewGen IEDC Center, that is New Generation Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development Center. It is a great opportunity for the students to exhibit their ideas. So their ideas can be transformed into products and prototypes and products. Those products may commercialized and converted into or marketized into startups. So it's a great opportunity for the students, and most of our students are utilizing that opportunity. And under this NewGen IEDC, we can extend our financial support up to 2.5 lakhs for each project. So girls are utilizing this opportunity. And we also collaborated with NETRA, that is National ESDM Technology and Research Academy. And we also strategic partner with the AI Deep Learning in artificial intelligence also. And we are also partner with the St. Louis University in the Center of Entrepreneurship Development. And SRIDW is a basic partner, as I told, AI Deep Learning, leadindia.in. And SRIDW organizes several workshops, lectures, and based upon entrepreneurship to inculcate and create, to bring out the creativity of the students and to bring them into, transform them into entrepreneurs and leaders. So I strongly believe that a teacher must be a lifelong learner, and he must be in a position to understand the latest technologies to teach the millennium students. So as a part of improving the teaching learning process, we are introducing several schemes to the faculty members, and we are continuously improving our teaching learning skills. We have collaborated with IUCEE, and through IUCEE we formed a cluster, and we have initiated three centers, that is Teaching Learning Center, Outcome Based Education, and Virtual Lab Centers. By these centers, our teachers are trained through these. And along with me, 10 of our faculty members are successfully completed IUCEE training program, where we can enhance our teaching learning skills. And not only this, we have established NPTEL Swayam portal in our local chapter in our college, so that faculty are trained and they are doing certification courses in through NPTEL. Which is, this is the second time they are doing. Already few of the faculty members completed their certification course. So by this, they are improving their technical skills through NPTEL Swayam portal. And our college CSSP team ensures that all the students registered get trained right from the first year onwards. And there is always try to shut the gap between the industry interaction and the educational academic linkages. As a part of training and placements, in the first year we are taking the help of Kandura Online, and the soft skills for the second years, aptitude for third years, and drive specific trainings and CRT for the final years. By going through all these training programs, the students are industry ready by the end of their fourth year. Along with this, we are also taking the help of TASK, where we can conduct several training programs and the POP sessions and the coding programs, especially under through TASK. And the current semester placements are 96, and the mostly 50% of the students are already placed, and we have still 1.5 month time for the completion of their course, and we are expecting more placements in the coming near future. And always, as Archana Madam and Sampat sir said, so always now up to in student phase, we mentor you, we guide you, but it is transformation phase for you. So now you are transforming from student phase to an employee. So now it is very important to maintain discipline and proper attitude. So whether you come to the classes regularly or not, we just like that, we have mentored you, we warn you, but it is not like that whenever you are in a company. So once if you are indisciplined, immediately you will be on bench. So keep it in mind and always maintain proper attitude. Once again, I would like to congratulate all the students and parents for your success, and all the best for your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I now request Dr. V. Mahesh, principal of SREC, to give his message.
Hey, Varada Reddy garu, and chief guest of today's function, Emmanuel Gosal garu, and director of this institution, Dr. C.V. Gururao garu, and principal of Women's Engineering College, Dr. Rajeshwi, deans, heads of the departments, faculty members, training and placement officers, CSSP coordinators, parents, and the future of the society, the young engineers sitting over here. Very good evening to all of you.
Yes, sir.
I said very good evening to all of you.
Yes, sir.
That should be the spirit. Maintain the josh.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. On behalf of SR Engineering College, first of all, I would like to thank our chief guest, Emmanuel Gosal garu, for accepting our invitation and coming all the way to Warangal to spend this late evening with us and to give valuable suggestions to all the boarding engineers sitting over here. Sir, we expect your message, what the industry is expecting from all these young engineers. SR Engineering College was started in the year 2002, and it was a very exciting journey during the past 17 years. We achieved several milestones in which we got the extensive cooperation from parents particularly, as well as all the faculty and staff members of our college. I take this opportunity to congratulate all the students sitting over here, as well as the parents, for getting placement in the reputed companies. I would like to appreciate the parents for the reason that our training programs are conducted even on holidays or during late hours also. But the parents have supported us by encouraging their children to attend all the training programs whenever they are scheduled. That is because of which they are able to get the employment today. Coming to SR Engineering College, became autonomous in the year 2014, and the National Assessment and Accreditation Council has accorded A-grade accreditation status to this college in the year 2014. I feel like today is a great day for us, because today morning itself, we received an information like National Board of Accreditation has accorded accreditation to all the BTEC programs of SR Engineering College in Tier 1 format. Tier 1 format is under the ambit of Washington Accord. It means the graduates of this college are globally recognized as possessing a quality degree. National Board of Accreditation is a quality assessing agency which accredits institutes in two different formats, Tier 1 category and Tier 2 category. Tier 1 is supposed to be the superior one, wherein the degree is valid as a quality degree across the 20 countries in the world, including US, UK and all other countries, Australia. And I congratulate all my faculty and staff in achieving this feat today. There are several other recognitions obtained by SR Engineering College. This college is recognized as Scientific and Industrial Research Organization by DST, Department of Science and Technology, by identifying the kind of research taken over by the faculty in the campus. And there is an organization called Indo-US Collaboration for Engineering Education, which networks US universities with Indian universities. That organization has recognized SR Engineering College for very good transformations in engineering education. The kind of curriculum that we offer, as just now Dr. Archana has told all of you, the kind of curriculum that offered by this college is very innovative. Innovation, creativity and entrepreneurship, these are the core values of this institution. Based on that, we have revised our curriculum extensively. Today, industry is expecting many skills from the students. It is just not pure academics. They need to possess different kinds of skill sets. Maybe the design skills, cognitive skills, leadership skills, communication skills, There are n number of such skills the industry is expecting today. So during the 4 years tenure of the student, 4 years tenure of the student here in the campus, we are trying to develop all such kind of skill sets right from first year level onwards. Our students, they develop products right from first year. We have a product design studio wherein they use 3D printers at first year level. They come up with very innovative products. And the kind of skill sets developed by the students is also very well appreciated by the industry today. And the other recognitions include, this is the first private engineering college in the state of Telangana to get a technology business incubator, which is where we are sitting today. A year back, Minister K.T. Rama Rao has inaugurated this technology business incubator. We name it as SR Innovation Exchange. Within this 1 year, already 25 startup companies are working in this campus. That is the major milestone of this college. And out of these 25 startup companies, only 4 or 5 companies are from Warangal, and remaining all are from different parts of the country. We have a company from Bhopal, we have a company from Chhattisgarh. Like that, spreading across the country, there are several startup companies working in this campus. And having a TPI in the campus is a very big motivation to our students, because they come to know how the startup works. Even the startup companies are offering internships to our students. And another big milestone for us is, this is the first private engineering college in the state of Telangana to have a women technology park in the campus, wherein we train women in the region on various technologies to empower them so that they become financially self-sustainable. Like this, there are many, many initiatives by SR Engineering College as the first institution in the region. And to develop the all-round performance of the students, any student will have 3 options. Either they can go for higher education, or they can go for placement, or they can become entrepreneur. They can start their own company. This campus provides opportunities for the students to go into any track. For going to higher education, we have a separate cell, career counseling cell, which guides our students about the opportunities, educational opportunities in India as well as in abroad. We have a separate CSSP cell, which continuously trains our students on various skill sets like aptitude, communication, C language, and all such things. It puts all efforts to place our students. And we have a third track, NEST for Entrepreneurship Development in Science and Technology, which conducts a series of programs based on, it may be weekly basis, monthly basis, or yearly basis. We conduct a weekly innovation challenge every week, which is open for all the students in the campus, wherein an impromptu challenge will be given to the students, and they are supposed to resolve that within the stipulated time, so that the students can work on the creative side of their mind. Directly or indirectly, all these things are helping our students in getting placements. There is a very interesting course which is very well appreciated by our students, named as Engineering Projects and Community Service. Our students, they approach different communities, they identify the societal problems, they try to build a product, they try to provide an engineering solution for the problems the communities are facing. Our students, they develop products for blind schools, they develop products for farmers, old age people, like that. They actually address the societal issues. That is what is expected from an engineer. So, I don't take much of your time. So these are all the skill sets developed in this college, because of which our placement rate is increasing year after year. Let me congratulate once again all the students and parents here. Thanks for the support extended all these days. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. I now request Dr. C.V. Gururao Garu, Director of SREC, to address the gathering.
Good evening, everybody. Sri Vardareddy Garu, Chairman of this institute, and Sri Emmanuel Gefla, the chief guest of today's function, Dr. Mahesh, Dr. Rajasri, and the deans, heads of departments, faculty members, parents of the placed students, and the student, in fact, we should not call you students now, almost 60 years. Term is over here and you are going to take up a job after receiving the offer letter here today. So I congratulate all those placed ones to take up the new assignment for them. So far it has been only a very freelancing study and completion of the course. I assure you that all of you will get through in your final examinations very soon, which will be declared in the form of results, and you receive your degrees. And before that, you receive your placement offer letter and take up a new job at your respective places where you have been placed. So, in fact, my predecessor speakers have given all the accounts of the do's and don'ts. But then, one thing remains is that after going from here, it is not that easy job. As already one of the principals told that, you will have to learn more and more every day. Why? Because at the industry, the environment is not similar to this institute, and you will have to seek and fight for the assignment that you are going to get. Those particularly who are placed in the IT, it is not that easy. I know people, a student, I know the persons took maybe 6 months to 1 year to get an assignment at the industry. So is that from today onwards, it is not the end of the story, but it is the beginning of your career. So you will have to learn new technologies, new softwares, and every day you will have to learn new things and go, so that you will be placed comfortably in your organization very well. Otherwise, you will not sustain that position. That is what is this one. So in this regard, the parent job is also not ends by receiving the offer letter here. The parent job is also begins to continue to give a moral support to the placed one, at least for a year, so that they settle down in their position and reach the new heights. All along, all these placed students, we expect you to come back whenever we call to help us hereafter, and also try to give new inputs to build the new curriculum and also new practices at this institute, so that it will help for your juniors. It will be a very good help for your juniors. That is what we request. I wish every one of you a very best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now comes the much awaited talk of the day. I deem it a pleasure to introduce the chief guest, Emmanuel Gosala, a senior resource development manager at EPAM Systems. He has handled entire HR and TA functions. He is experienced in coaching and advising business leaders, managers, and employees on HR policy and processes. He has implemented competency-based PMS, Compare Issue,
and instrumental in designing online PMS, internet and leave management internal tools. He has worked closely with colleagues across US, Australia and Europe. He has received CEO, COE and several Star of the Quarter awards. Also, he is an active member of NHRD, HICIA HR Forum and XLRI alumni. He had conducted and organized 6 annual outings or events, several quarterly events successfully. In present, he is working as a Senior Resource Development Manager at EPAM Systems. Also, he has an experience as a Regional Head for People and Culture at Octum. He has an experience as a HR Manager at Alliance Global Services and many more. He is an MBA graduate, HR and Systems from Osmania University. We now have a pleasure of listening to him. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
It's a very warm weather, right? Yes, no? I'm sure I see a lot of smiles and proud parents. So I would like to do a quick exercise. It's good to have an exercise in the evening. What are the students? I request all the students to raise from their chairs, stand up. Can you please do that for me? Okay, great. Can you please pat on the back of your friend sitting next to you or standing next to you saying congratulations? Don't hit them. Just say congratulations, good job. Okay, thank you. Please be seated. So this evening I would like to start my address by telling you 3 stories which are real life stories and which has impacted me in a big way. And the parents and the management, the faculty who are sitting here, maybe you can help me in identifying who is this person I'm speaking about. And I'm sure the students who are sitting, maybe you can also give it a try. When he was born, the country was under British rule. When he started his political career, his party was barely present. When he passed away, the party people he groomed or inspired are President, Vice President, Lok Sabha Speaker, Prime Minister, entire Cabinet, Chief Ministers of 22 states, and governors of 30 states. Now, this is called lifetime work and ability to build an organization as a leader. Can anyone tell me who is that leader? He has transformed the entire country and the people who are following him. Any guess, anyone wants to say who is this leader I'm referring to? He is a unique example. Can I reveal the answer? He's a unique example of transformational leadership, of taking things from scratch to diamonds. He is none other than a great leader, Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee. I think we should give him a big round of applause. Under his leadership, just imagine, President, Vice President, Prime Minister, 22 states chief ministers and 30 states governors, they all has grown under his leadership. Today, you have been achieved something. I'm talking to the young engineers who are sitting in front of me. You're going to start your journey of your career. The next story which I want to talk about is someone who I know. He is an IITian. He delivered lots and millions worth of IT projects. And he has mentored many IT leaders and people like me to become very successful leaders in the organization.
and at the age of 55, he is retired with 3 crores of cash in his bank balance. And of course, apart from other real estate properties. And he's achieved leader in the IT industry. This is the second story which I wanted to share with all of you. But when I talk to him today, he's getting bored at home. Do you know why? He never spent any time outside his work. He never had a hobby. He never went out of his house. He never went out of his company to go and help the society. He was always career focused, which is very good. Look at the two leaders whom I'm speaking about. And I'm sure you're also going to be a leader down the line. So what I have learned from these two great leaders, whom I have personally know them, or I have read about them, what I have learned in life, is there are no shortcuts in life. Many engineers who join, I have been handling the students who join in our organization, sometimes students want to have a shortcuts. There are no shortcuts in life to be successful. You need to keep working hard. Imagine you are going to gym. Can you get the shape of your body in 1 day, 2 days, 3 days? Every day you have to keep spending. And there is a dentist who keeps saying that you should visit a dentist once in a year. If you properly brush your teeth every day, twice, at least for 2 minutes. If you say that, you know, I go and visit the doctor once in a year and I don't want to do every day my brush, my teeth, who is going to get impacted? It's me. So I need to work every day to achieve what I need to want in my life. Be humble and have a vision. This is something where many of the students lack, because once they get an offer, that's it. They achieve the greatest thing in the world and they stop learning. Many organizations, if you Google it, and what are the challenges of the organizations, what they're going through, first thing is recruitment, second is attrition, third is learning. Once the employee joins the company, they stop learning. They get trained. There is a lot of difference between training and learning. Please understand the difference between training and learning. You've been trained all these days, but your learning will continue your lifelong. So you need to be a lifelong learner. The next point, what I have learned, is don't run behind the money. I see in the report that highest salary package is 10 lakhs and the least is some 2 lakh rupees. Never run behind the money. Money will follow you if you have basic fundamentals and values. Once you get into certain stage where you are going to compromise with your values, if you run behind money, trust me, I have seen people who lost their jobs after 6 years, 7 years, or 10 years, and today they are not having a right way of earnings. And the next one is have hobbies. Spend your time in serving the society. If you join any organization today, which is an MNC, you will not even have an opportunity to talk to people very often, because everything is automated. Everything is digitalized. Even your onboarding can happen online. Before even you join with us, even in our company, there's no need for my team to come sit with you and make everything to, you know, take you through. Everything is automated. So where is the opportunity for you to talk and spend time with people? The human relations are something which is important. So go and serve the society. This is the lessons which I have learned. Now what can you do now? You completed your engineering. What I have done when I have done my master's MBA, I have written, thank you. So you want me to stop or you're appreciating? I take it as an appreciation. Okay. So what I have done when I have completed my MBA. I have written what do I need to achieve in the next 5 years, 10 years and 15 years. If you are retiring, when you go back home and when you join the organization, please take your time and write your own retirement address. What will your colleagues or your family members talk about you at the end of your retirement? If you have that, trust me, you will have a great corporate life. Now, I also see parents. I want to give a few advices to the parents because I do handle 1,200 employees. I handle students who join in my organization. I also have people. I do take part in various associations. And I have 3 advices for parents. Probably I speak in Telugu. తల్లిదండ్రులు ఉన్నారు ఇక్కడ. మీ పిల్లలకు జాబ్ వచ్చింది, చాలా మంచిది, సంతోషంగా ఉన్నారు. యూ షుడ్ ఫీల్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ అండ్ ప్రౌడ్. మీ పిల్లలకి 3 విషయాలు చెప్పాలని నేను అనుకుంటున్నాను. కంపెనీలో జాయిన్ అవుతున్నారు, మంచిది, వెరీ గుడ్. టీమ్ మెంబర్స్ని ఎలా రెస్పెక్ట్ చేయాలి, అవతల వాళ్ళ వ్యూస్ని కూడా రెస్పెక్ట్ చేయాలనేది నేర్పించాలి. అవతల వాళ్ళని యాక్సెప్ట్ చేయాలి, ద వే దే ఆర్. వాళ్ళు ఎలా ఉన్నారో అలాగే యాక్సెప్ట్ చేయాలి. మీరు అక్కడ వెళ్ళి అవతల వాళ్ళని మారుస్తారంటే కుదరదు. పిల్లలు వాళ్ళతో వర్క్ చేసి ఆ ప్రాజెక్ట్ కంప్లీట్ చేయించాలి. నాకు మేనేజర్ సరిగా లేడు, టీం మెంబర్ సరిగా లేడు అని కంప్లైంట్ చేస్తే పిల్లలకి నేర్పించాల్సిన బాధ్యత పేరెంట్స్దే. అది ఎలా నేర్చుకుంటారు? నేను చూస్తాను ఫెస్టివల్స్కి కానీ ఏదైనా ఫంక్షన్స్కి కానీ పిల్లలు ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఇంటికి వెళ్ళరు, ఫ్రెండ్స్తోనే టైం స్పెండ్ చేయాలనుకుంటారు. మరి ఎక్కడ నేర్చుకుంటారు ఈ వాల్యూస్ పిల్లలు? వెన్ దే గెట్ ఇన్ యువర్ కార్పొరేట్ లైఫ్, దే గో ఇన్ వర్క్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్, బెంగళూర్, చెన్నై, ఎక్కడైనా ఉండొచ్చు. మరి పేరెంట్స్ పిల్లలకి మీ టీమ్ మెంబర్స్తో వాళ్ళు ఎలా ఉన్నా వాళ్ళని యాక్సెప్ట్ చేయాలి అండ్ వర్క్ చేయగలగాలి. Second thing is, teach them the values of relations. Third one, tell them to help the society. మొత్తం ఇప్పుడు రోబోటిక్స్ వచ్చేస్తాయి, రోబోట్స్ వచ్చి వర్క్ చేస్తున్నాయి, మొత్తం కంప్యూటరైజేషన్ అయిపోయింది, మనుషులతో మాట్లాడే ఛాన్స్ చాలా తక్కువ. ఫ్యామిలీ రిలేషన్స్ వాల్యూస్ ఇప్పటి నుంచి ఇంకా ఎక్కువగా నేర్పించాలి. ఎందుకంటే దే ఆర్ ఇండిపెండెంట్, ఎవరి మీద డిపెండ్ అవ్వాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. దే ఆర్ ఎర్నింగ్ మనీ. పెళ్ళిళ్ళు ఎవరైనా ఉంటే పెళ్ళిళ్ళకి రారు, హ్యాపీ మూమెంట్స్ అంటే షేర్ చేసుకోరు, సాడ్ మూమెంట్స్ అంటే చేసుకోరు. అది తల్లిదండ్రులు పిల్లలకు నేర్పించాలి. నేను ఎందుకు చెప్పాలనుకున్నానంటే, వెన్ దే గెట్ మ్యారీడ్, బోత్ విమెన్ అండ్ మెన్, దే హ్యావ్ డిఫరెన్సెస్ ఇన్ దేర్ మ్యారిటల్ ఇష్యూస్. పెళ్ళి అయిన తర్వాత ఈ ఇద్దరు వైఫ్ అండ్ హస్బెండ్స్ గొడవ పడుతున్నారు, ఒకరి ఫ్యామిలీ అంటే ఒకటి పడట్లేదు, స్పెషల్లీ ఇన్ వర్కింగ్ కపుల్స్. సో ఐ అడ్వైజ్ పేరెంట్స్ టు ప్లీజ్ టీచ్ యువర్ చిల్డ్రన్ అబౌట్ రిలేషన్స్ అండ్ ఫ్యామిలీస్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద 2 థింగ్స్ విచ్ ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు టెల్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్ అండ్ ద పేరెంట్స్ బికాస్ దే ఆర్ స్టార్టింగ్ ఇన్ దర్ జర్నీ ఇన్ టు అ న్యూ కార్పొరేట్ వరల్డ్. Reports from GI read that 70% of the students got offers in IT industry, which is a very fast growing industry, which is good, but you need to know what you are going to achieve. So let me close by telling one story, how you can get motivated and how you can learn yourself. In the jungle, which animal is the biggest? Which animal is the biggest? I hear you, elephant. In the jungle, which animal is the tallest? Giraffe. In the jungle, which animal is the wisest? Fox. In the jungle, which animal is the fastest? Cheetah. Among all these wonderful qualities mentioned, where is the lion in this story? We say lion is the king of the jungle, even without having any of these qualities. You know why? Because the lion is courageous, the lion is very bold, the lion is always ready to face any challenges, any barrier that crosses his path, no matter how big or bad they are. The lion walks with confidence, the lion dares anything and is never afraid. So, what is that we get to learn from the lion? You don't need to be the fastest in your team, in the organization. You don't need to be the wisest in your team or organization. You don't need to be the smartest. You don't need to be the most brilliant. You don't need to be generally accepted and achieve your dreams and be a great leader in life. All you need is courage, boldness, and the will to try. And all you need is the faith to believe it is possible. All you need is to believe in yourself that you can do it. It's time to bring out the lion in you. Stay motivated, focus on your journey of life, journey of learning. Face the terrible, face it boldly. Congratulations, and I wish you all the best in your journey. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You've really been inspiring. We now have the chairman, Sri A. Vardareddy Garu, addressing the gathering.
Chief guest of this function, Sri Emmanuel Bhusla Garu, Director of this college, Dr. C. V. Gurrao Garu, Principal of this college, Dr. V. Mahesh Garu, Principal of our Women's College, Dr. I. Rajasthi Madam, and other Dean of different branches, head of the departments, teachers, respected parents, my dear students, and other reporters. Good evening. Actually, I am the chairman of the SR Education Society. I always should talk last. This is the difficulty I am facing always. Chairman, ఎప్పుడు లాస్ట్ కే మాట్లాడాలి ఇందరు మాట్లాడినా ఏం మాట్లాడినా ప్రశాంతంగా కూర్చోవాలి కాబట్టి నాకు చాలా ప్రశాంతత ఉంది కింద ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కంగ్రాచులేట్ ఆల్ ది ఇంజనీర్స్ ఆర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ హు గాట్ ప్లేస్మెంట్స్ ఇన్ ది డిఫరెంట్ సెక్టర్స్ మై అప్రిషియేషన్ టు ది పేరెంట్స్ ఇవాళ ఇంజనీర్స్ అందరూ బాగా సెలెక్ట్ అయ్యారు నిజమే కానీ ఇంకా రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ ఎక్కువ మీకు బికాస్ యూ సర్వ్ ది పీపుల్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ సర్వీస్ అండ్ ఆల్ ది పీపుల్ షుడ్ డెవలప్ ప్రజలకు అభివృద్ధి లేని పని ఏది ఉండదు మీరు సాఫ్ట్వేర్లో పనిచేయండి హార్డ్వేర్లో పనిచేయండి ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫర్ ది డెవలప్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ సొసైటీ మీరేదో అంత సింపుల్ అనుకుంటే కాదు ఇంకా బాగా రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ పెరిగింది మీకు ఇప్పుడు స్టూడెంట్ నుంచి సర్వీస్ వెళ్ళిపోయింది మీకు మీరు సర్వీస్ చేయటం వల్ల జాబ్ చేయటం వల్ల మీకు డబ్బు వస్తుంది కానీ మీరు పనిచేయటం వల్ల ఈ దేశం అంతా ఈ ప్రపంచం అంతా డెవలప్ ఈ చదువు యొక్క ముఖ్యమైన ఉద్దేశం అది ఫ్యామిలీ పరంగా మీకు సెట్ కావాలి అంటే మీకు డబ్బు వస్తుంది మీరు పనిచేయటం వలన ఈ దేశం అంతా అభివృద్ధి చెందుతుంది కాబట్టి మీరు ఒకటి ఒక ఇండస్ట్రీస్లో జాయిన్ అయ్యిండు కానీ అక్కడ పనిచేస్తలేదు ఇంకొకసారి ఆ ఇండస్ట్రీ కాలేజ్ రానేరా. ఎందుకు రాదంటే ఇక్కడికి పోయిన వాళ్ళందరూ లేజీ ఫెలోస్, అక్కడ వర్క్ లేదు, టాలెంట్ లేదు, తర్వాత ఇంకా డెవలప్ అయితలేదు, లీడర్షిప్ క్వాలిటీస్ లేవు, ఇంకా నేర్చుకోవటం లేదంటే ఎస్ఆర్ కాలేజ్ వచ్చిన స్టూడెంట్స్ లేదా సుమతి రెడ్డి వచ్చేటటువంటి స్టూడెంట్స్ ఏం చేయటం లేదు అని దీనికి ఒక బ్యాడ్ ఒపీనియన్ వస్తుంది. అంచేత మీరు ఈ కాలేజీ నుంచి పోయిండ్రు కాబట్టి మీరు బాగా వర్క్ చేయాలి. ఎప్పుడైనా కూడా సార్ చెప్పిన విషయం అంటే ఇవాళ స్టూడెంట్ చీఫ్ గెస్ట్ ఏం చెప్పిందంటే కంటిన్యూస్ ప్రాసెస్. నేను నాకు చెప్తా, ఐఎమ్ ది పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ ఇన్ ఫిజిక్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ఉస్మానియా యూనివర్సిటీ. ఐ జాయిన్ యాజ్ ఎ లెక్చరర్ ఇన్ గవర్నమెంట్ సెక్టర్, రిజైన్ ది జాబ్ అండ్ ఎస్ఆర్పిటీ ప్రైవేట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ 1976. నేను ఎట్లా పనిచేసిందంటే విపరీతమైన పనిచేసింది. నవ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ బీన్ రన్నింగ్ 108 ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్. ఏదో ఉత్తర వచ్చింది కాదు, ఏదో ఏదో స్టైల్ కొరం చేసింది కాదు, ఇది ఒకటి సిస్టమేటిక్ ఆర్డర్ చేయాలి. అండ్ రీసెంట్లీ 10 డేస్ బ్యాక్ మీ శాంక్షన్ ది మెడికల్ కాలేజ్ ఆల్సో. నేను అభిప్రాయం ఇదంతా ఎందుకు చెప్తున్నానంటే బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది హార్డ్ వర్క్ సిన్సర్ ఎఫర్ట్ అంటే నో షార్ట్ కట్ మెథడ్ సార్ చెప్పేది. నో షార్ట్ కట్ మెథడ్, నో పాలిటిక్స్, సింపుల్ హార్డ్ వర్క్, సిన్సర్ ఎఫర్ట్ అంటే మీరు ఆ ఫీల్డ్లో పోతున్నారు ఇప్పుడు అంతే. ఉద్యోగం దొరికింది దొరికిందంటే అక్కడేదో చిన్న పని కాదు, అసలు భవిష్యత్ అంతా మీ చేతిలోనే ఉంది. మీ భవిష్యత్ ఉంది, ఈ సమాజం భవిష్యత్తు ఉంది మీ చేతిలో. అంచేత బాగా వర్క్ చేయండి, మీరు కుటుంబ పరంగా బాగా సెటిల్ కాండి, మన ఈ దేశం అంతా అభివృద్ధి చెందాలి. అయితే ఒక 2 నిమిషాలు ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ అని చెప్తా, తర్వాత సుమతి రెడ్డి కాలేజీ గురించి చెప్తా. ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజీకి నిన్న 28 నాడు ఇంతకుముందు ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారు చెప్పిండ్రు, ఏం లేదంటే ఎన్బిఏ టైర్ 1 వచ్చింది. ఎన్బిఏ టైర్ 1 అక్రిడిషన్ వచ్చిందంటే ఇదేదో మామూలు కాదు, ప్రపంచంలో అన్ని దేశాలు కలిసి అసలు ఇంజనీరింగ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఎట్లా ఉండాలి, ఎట్లా ఉంటే మంచిగా ఉంటుంది అని వాషింగ్టన్లో ఒక మీటింగ్ పెట్టుకున్నాం. దానికి కొన్ని రూల్స్ రెగ్యులేషన్స్ అన్ని ఫ్రేమ్ చేసింది, దాన్ని వాషింగ్టన్ అకార్డ్ అంటాం. మన ఇండియాలో కూడా వాషింగ్టన్ అకార్డ్లో మనం కూడా మెంబర్. మన దగ్గర ఎన్బిఏ అక్రిడిషన్ టైర్ 1 వచ్చిందంటే వాషింగ్టన్ అకార్డ్లో ఉన్నట్టు లెక్క. మనం ప్రపంచంలో ఎక్కడ పోయినా ఉద్యోగం చేయొచ్చు, ప్రపంచంలో ఎక్కడైనా కూడా సింపుల్గా ఏం చేయాలంటే మనం ఎడ్యుకేషన్ చేయొచ్చు. ఇది ఒక వండర్ఫుల్ అక్రిడిషన్, ఇది స్టాంప్, ఇది ఎస్ఆర్ కాలేజ్ సింపుల్ కాదు, చిన్నది కూడా కాదు. ఇదేదో మొత్తం తెలంగాణలో టోటల్గా 5 ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్కే ఉన్నాయి టైర్ 1 ఎన్బి అక్రిడిషన్. అందులో అన్ని బ్రాంచెస్కి ఉన్నాయి, ఓన్లీ 3 కాలేజెస్కే ఉన్నాయి. ఎందుకు చెప్తున్నానంటే మనం ఎప్పుడైనా మన ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ను ప్రేమించాలి, మన పేరెంట్స్ను ప్రేమించాలి, మన ఉద్యోగాన్ని ప్రేమించాలి. ఇది మన ధర్మం, ఇట్లా ఉండాలి. మన ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ అనేది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ అనేది ఏ ప్రైమరీ స్కూల్ కానీ, మిడిల్ స్కూల్ కానీ, హై స్కూల్ కానీ, ఇంజనీరింగ్ కానీ, ఏ దాని మీద అయినా కూడా మనకు లవ్ అండ్ అఫెక్షన్ ఉండవలసింది. అంచేత ఇటువంటి కాలేజ్ ఇది. అట్లనే సుమతిరెడ్డి కాలేజ్ కూడా ఇంకా మేము దీనికి సిస్టర్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్, అది దీన్ని ప్రకారం దాన్ని ఎట్లా డెవలప్ చేయాలో అట్లా చేస్తామంటే అది కూడా మెల్లమెల్లగా దీంతో ఫాలో అవుతున్నది, అది కూడా బాగానే అవుతుంది. అంచేత మై స్పెషల్ థ్యాంక్స్ టు టుడే చీఫ్ గెస్ట్ హు హ్యావ్ గివెన్ వండర్ఫుల్ మెసేజ్ టు యూ అండ్ పేరెంట్స్, అండ్ ఆల్సో మై స్పెషల్ కంగ్రాచులేషన్ టు ఆల్ ది స్టూడెంట్స్ హు గాట్ ది జాబ్స్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ ఇండస్ట్రీస్. మై స్పెషల్ థ్యాంక్స్ టు ది పేరెంట్స్ ఆల్సో. ఐ విష్ యూ ఆల్ ది బెస్ట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ అన్నమాట.